It says yes. Now, is it on? Yeah. Yeah? Could people hear me already or not?
No?
No? So, should we stop? Yeah, okay. Stop. Yeah, just cut it off and then we start again.
No.
Oh, yeah, just keep on going. Okay. So, we need to start over again. It was a happy Friday again. And we'll cut the first part off. Let me see. I forgot to put my mic on. So, that was not a good beginning of the Friday. If I put the comments on, I can actually... Oh, I can actually see you. Okay, and I should have read the comments already. So, journal your December and December day by day. So, I told already without the mic, make sure to find your inspiration in the groups because there's so much going on and it's really, really nice. And I also told you, I'm going to tell you one that I will copy from one of the design team members. I think I've seen it twice already, but such fun, fun ideas. So, what I want to do... And I need to tell you about the brand ambassador. If you go to our Facebook page and you might have seen it already in an email, we are looking for design team members for the collection from Josette and from the beautiful blooms from Diane and Sonia. So if you're interested to become a brand ambassador for Elizabeth Craft Designs in 2022, you know, look on Facebook, on our Facebook page, and you will see the post there. It's pinned to the top. So read about it, and then you can send your information to Josette if you're interested. So let's turn the camera around, and then we get started. So what I want to do... okay, there we are. So it's working. Okay. I have, you know, there's technical things all the time, but this was just me forgetting the putting the sound on. So you see I have three here, so this is going to be my December day by day, and this is going to be my journal your December, and in this one I worked a little bit more already because we had that on the craft store already, and this is going to be the weekend. So hi Honora, so good to see you. Hello Mariette, nice to see you as well, everybody. And so I'm going to put this, and of course here I have the samples, and I'm going to do a little show and tell, and then I'm going to start, because I have a lot to show in this one already, and kind of talk about it, mixing and matching, because you know I love to do that. So this one, here you have the, you know, oh I should take these two out, maybe I use those today. So here you got that shutter. And for that shutter, I cut out the circle already, and that's to remind me that you can also do that in the journal. So that's what I love about it, that you can really can mix and match. You see, here you see the stamp. So just quickly, that little snow globe I made, I actually put in my journal. And then Mary, everything is going to be on a card today with Esther made for me. So just really fun. So that is if you choose the sidekick. And of course you can mix and match everything in there as well. So I will show you that in another life for sure. So I'm going to work on this one today. So here I told you already I have all kind of pages in there. So I'm actually going to make my own. This is from Esther. I'm going to make my own starter page here. And you see, so working in that one today. But what I want to show you is what I did in this one already. So first of all, and I thought about that this morning, that shutter one that I showed you, and Esther showed you that it can go on the camera if you have the camera kits. Hi, David. Hi, Karen. When will you store have the new releases? Oh, I think somewhere end of next week or something. So, yeah. So you see this one, that it can go in the square one as well. So, yeah, I know, Belinda, we have... fantastic new releases. We had those in the month of November. Yeah, the shutter is super cool, and I saw already the first results, and some people are still waiting on their delivery because everywhere, and let me say, oh there you go, arrived about half an hour ago. Okay, that is great, Sir Stampalot, because that was my next remark. I saw a store in the Netherlands as well. Marloesje said, if you really want to have it tomorrow, you need to come to the store. Because, and it's the same all over the world at the moment. Shipping is not, you know, that accurate at the moment. And it's for everything. We try FedEx, we try UPS, we try Post. It's, you know, it's everywhere. Although we have a fantastic lady at the moment. I met her this morning that picks up our post. So one truckload went already today. So And I'm going to, so this is your seal. So I'm going to show you what is new. So you can imagine this one on a circle page shutter will be fantastic. So keep that in mind. Definitely going to do that one. But I did work on this one, so I did make these. I did some of the themes. So I know there was a Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So that's this one. I put it on a little wobbler. And there's a story to that. So that's my own story, because somebody is saying, you know, that it's nice if you, you know, can like a little story with everything. I am, okay, there we go. A lot of comments. Yeah, so I did this because where we live, I have seen this guy kind of shaving off his antlers, shaving the, kind of the, you know, scraping off the fur from his antlers. And that is rough. That is honestly really rough. So I did this just for myself to remind. Then this morning I put that window in that I made earlier with the deer. And then I have the pine trees there. I have the mountain. I have a little deer here. And then I thought about my... I had a music book, an old one from The Sound of Music. And The Hills Are Alive. I thought that was a fun one to put there. So I did that there. First time here, Keshua. Welcome. So that was not off to a good start, because I started with no sounds. Oh, Claudia. Okay. Life as recovering from the dental work. Oh, that's yeah. So that's that one. Then I did this one. So I posted this earlier, actually with a back on it, so that you could stand it up. But now I have it, I put it in the journal here, just to show you that you can do this in your journal as well. My screen is frozen, but no, it's not on there, so we're fine. And then this one I really like, because this one, those pictures, so I wanted to show you that I have a pocket there, so that's from an earlier release from the journals. These pictures are actually going to be the 1st of December, because I asked Daniela to send me some pictures from the baby room, because that's the big event this month, of course. So that's going to be in my December day by day. So then here you see, and I'm going to bring this one up because this is actually super cool. I used real pine cones, and I'm going to show you. Yeah, I'm just going to refresh my screen, because my screen is now frozen. You know, sometimes it's not always going as I want it to be. So I don't see the comments at the moment because my screen is frozen. I'm just going to start it up again, but I don't think it works. So I'm going to bring this one up, and then I'm going to tell you what I did, because the pieces you see here are actually from real pine cones. So let me bring this up, and I hope it's sharp. You see? So those are real pine cones. So those actually look super cool. And what I did... Mark, can you check if you can bring my comments back? I'm just going to give the iPad to Mark quickly, so he can fix that for me. And so what I did there, I actually had a real pine cone. I still have it here. I kind of took off all the side pieces. And depending on the pine cone you use, they're different, because we have a lot of different pine cones. I know I was kind of joking with Rihanna, because Rihanna couldn't find one. And we have a lot, of course. So I have all these pieces. And then Rihanna made a fantastic, beautiful pinecone paste, by the way. So that's what I used here. So I just put that on. And you know, I like to do those things. So I just had paper double-sided adhesive. And then I added those little pinecone pieces on there. So it is super simple. It's just, you know, I just did that while watching TV. So I just put them on here, and then you run that through with this over it, run it through your die cutting machine to flatten it out. And then I die cut it. And the die cut I used over there is an like the old pine cone from Suzanne. There's not in stock anymore. I had something similar, and I had one designer seeing using it as well. But, you know, any pine cone, of course, that's fine. But it's just a fantastic... Oh, thank you, Mark. I have you back here. Let me see if I got... Yeah, so that's what I did. Are they the pine cones you put through your die cutting machine? Yeah, so these are the... So I put these through my die cutting machine. And then what you see here, that's kind of a fun story as well. Because I have... here I have little wood pieces... Those are actually the ones that came out of the windows. I saved those and I thought, oh, I need to do something with that. And I kind of started to build something there, and then I just put the pine cones over it. But all those pieces that fall out... And oh, my Luz has a message. more losers sending me a message. Here you go. You see, so these ones, those pieces that fell out of the window, that's the one I used over here. So that's that one. And so that's that. What else did I do? I did an ornament here. So this is some stenciling from Ilse and Charlene. Here's another ornament. This one I made, you saw that already. I made that at the craft store with the Christmas tree in there. This one I created. And I know I have something else I want to show you. Oh, this one. So that's that pocket. And then this, I made this. So that's, you recognize that pocket from Ilse and Charlene. But then I added the tag from the wave pocket. And it was the exact height. So that just fits perfectly in there. So you can use that tag and then put a picture on it. Then this one from the book from Esther, it says Marry Everything. You see, that fits perfectly in here as well. But I'm going to take this because I will use that on a card in a second. You see, so there's all kind of things I tried. There's one more thing I wanted to show you. Of course, that's James. Okay, so the tags from Esther fit perfectly. Same height, you see? So you can put those in pockets there. So really mix and match it all together. And then this one, and I know this one is not, we're sold out of it, it's not coming back. But if you have that hard double page from Esther, that is a fun one to put in your square one. You see, so I just wanted to give you that idea because I know a lot of you will have it. It's not coming back with us, but if you have it, that's one you can cut for your December day by day or your journal. Or, and what I did is I covered the holes here with a piece of fabric. So that is that one. I'm going to put the pictures back in here because I don't think I will put the pictures in there today. But that will go in my journal. Or in my December day by day, sorry. So what I want to do, I want to work on a part that I have done already. So I have two pages basically ready to go. And I don't know, I probably don't finish them completely. Because I just, you know, just play and see how far I get. What I want to do, so my first page will be the deer and the trees, and because that's just, you know, where we are, so I like to use that as my first page. And then I'm going to work on the candles as well. So what I did, I cut that page out of the book three, of course, and that is absolutely flying. So if you don't have that yet, well, in the US it's not flying anywhere because it's not here yet, but in Europe they're going really, really fast. And I hope I asked you, but there was no news yet for here. So then I added some snow. And what I, how I did that, and I'm going to show you that quickly. I used that, I actually like that stuff. The, you know, and I know there's a lot of different snows out there. Just going to put this in the center a little bit. I know there's a lot of snows out there, but I just, you know, I happen to have this one and I like it. And what I did with the tree, I actually etched the sides first with distress ink. And then when I started to add the snow, it turned a little bit green because of the ink, which is fine in this case. I will fly when you get, I know, Michelle, it is, it needs to get here, but well, you know, it is just not fun at the moment. But it is what it is, so we're just going to, you know, work with it. So what I did in this case, I just put a little bit on a sheet. And then I took my tree and I just dipped it in, like this. And that was a super easy, and you can do a little bit like this as well, like just dip it in like this. And then you get like your tips, you see, so it just picks up on your tips. And that is just an easy way, instead of adding it with a palette knife or something, this was so much easier. And it's kind of fun stuff. And then you get it uneven as well. And that's kind of, a lot of times my challenge that I think is going to be not too even. And in this case, it is not. A little bit here. You see, and then you just kind of, you know, you kind of look at it and you think, okay, that's nice. And then the rest, you see, can go back. So that's good. And then the rest, so this, I'm going to put that on the side, just goes back in your jar. I know it's, yeah, we'll, yeah, exactly, Michelle. As soon as it's here. And it was, I think we're talking 2 weeks ago now for sure. It was in the New York Harbor already. But we all know that even the harbors are not really reliable place where you want to have your stuff. That's why we had that creative thing to bring in the journals from Ilse and Charlene in a burlap bag. And you've seen that. Let me show you one, because I have them here. So we have the two, and they actually, when you get those, they come in a burlap bag, because that was the way when we could fly it in. So yeah, we need to be creative about that as well. Oh, lava paste. That's probably the same, isn't it? I know Ilse and Charlene, I think they work with lava paste. But I don't have that. I don't have that. Reboot it. And you're back. Where you gone, Honora? It's something with technique and me. You see, it's not... So this one, what I will do, I will work on the candles first, because then this can dry. I have my deer, all my deer, you see. And I'm going to build that, but let that dry first. So what I want to do then, I want to work on my candles. And what I did already, let me make a quick card as well. You know, I made these already earlier, and now I'm going to do them on the page. But I had these candles, I had this, so I just want to make a quick card as well to show you. Oh, the one I have. Yeah, the one I have, but the lava paste, I don't know. This is a snow text. It's, you know, it's they call it snow. But I know Ilse and Charlene work a lot with lava paste. But I don't think I could get it at the time, because I don't have it. I know. Nice snowy tree. It would be nice if we get a snow here. But so this, of course, is also from the book. So that's all the reminiscence. I know the candles are absolutely beautiful. And then the small one again. So the small one fits in this again, you see. So you can use that there. But that candle is beautiful for in your sidekick, for in your planner, or for on cards. Lava paste you need to heat. Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Oh, then it puffs up. Okay. And is that nice? Because sometimes when things puff up, I think it's too much. So depending, oh, is that stuff that what they used with the mushrooms? Was that lava paste? I don't know that. Would love to know if that was the lava paste that they used on the, yeah, glitter accent, nice for a frosty look, absolutely. And I wanted to make glitter candles as well, but that's not going to happen today. So I might just do that at home and then show you, because that technique. Oh, they don't have it. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. You know, that's there's a lot of things that is a problem to get. And we actually just placed an order for something. And that's a totally different product. And the problem they have is the packaging. Paper. And we already got like the next book will be more expensive because paper is increased in price. So there's a lot going on. A lot going on. Oh, that was the lava paste on the... Okay, thank you. That was on the mushroom. That's answer, I think. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Then I definitely don't have that. I do have fluffy stuff from... Oh, I need to... I have something, because that's why I said I cleaned up my craft room. I have something from... I think from Cosmic... Oh, you have lava paste, Michelle? I need to order it from you then. I have something Cosmic Shimmer or something. That kind of looks the same, maybe. I didn't try that yet. Oh, yeah, no, the candles are for a lot of different... Else. Oh, I can leave. No, I cannot leave that. That's actually the back of my cards, Else. You see, talking at... I should have done it on the black. Wait, because I do flat cards when I do it here, because it's easier. So that's the back. But you see with the tape, you can roll it off. And you see that right away as well. Okay, did I put pay? No, I did. You see, I should have done it on there. Probably the comments are scrolling later. And then, yeah, lava paste is from course. Oh, maybe I have a little bottle with a tip. Is that it? I think it's, it is Cosmic Shimmer what I have at home. I need to look now right away when I'm home again. Cosmic Shimmer, if it's shimmer, yeah, then it's not. I have a little bottle. It says that it's fluffy stuff, I think. Yeah. I know, Mercedes, that's what I think as well. That's what I think as well. The best double-sided adhesive around. Let's see, I did it wrong. Pull this towards me a bit so I can center it. And I always do like 3/16 of an inch smaller when I layer, because just 2/16 is not enough for me. Then, you know, then it's harder to line it up nicely. No, lava paste is a jar. Okay, then. Okay, that's something different. Okay. Oh, I will give you cake. No, I spend, you know, and it's so nice. And you know what the advantage is now? That I make a lot of miles in my craft room. Because I put everything back now right away. Which is fantastic. Which is fantastic. So, of course, this is the paper from the book. And then I thought, like this one has adhesive on the back. And how I did this one, I actually used this and I trimmed this. Kind of to layer it on there. So, just as a, I just cut this piece. And then I layered my candles on there. Okay, now wait, let me see. This, and this. Or, because now I wanted to use that marry everything. Because look, that will be really nice here. Yeah, I do it that way. Oh, you would love to have a craft room to clean. Yeah, no. If you come to me and you know, I always have a lot of stuff to clean. No, I try to keep it nice then. But you know, it's always when there's hurry and you know you're in a hurry again, then it's always things go bad again. But I try. I try. Melissa, thank you. Yeah, it's how did you train yourself to put things away in the correct place? Sharon, that's only when it's when I just finished cleaning. Because the hours you spend on searching for stuff, I'm going to put this a little bit higher. The amount of time you spend on searching for stuff, it's worth to kind of put it back right away. Are they straight? They are. And now this one I'm going to put here. This one I made before. That's one I actually had around, laying around here. There was actually white paint on it. So I took that off. I don't know how I did that, but I splattered on it. And this one, I know Anita put it in her journal. And then, so this of course has dimension. Pia, so that's why you need to go to our group. Because Pia, from she made from the design team. She made a page in her planner using the poinsettia. And that, of course, is this. I know I have it here somewhere. Well, not right now. Oh, yeah, here. But so it's this one, the Florals 12 that I used here. And Pia made it flat because then it's a flat page in your planner. But look at that. And then this one is actually made by Esther. Now I should see if I have a little piece of twine because that kind of finishes it off. I do have that. I have a scissor. Do I have a stapler here? No, I don't. So I'm just going to kind of attach it to that. And normally I would staple that. And I thought I had a stapler here. Let me see. Or maybe not. No, no stapler. I need an extra Tim stapler. But if I glue this down, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of glue here. And what Esther did, so she stamped one of the stamps, which is this one, that little, that's in the Hello December. So it's that little stamp here, so a reinforcement stamp. And then she added a little glue. She added an eyelet. Yeah, isn't it? Yeah, that's what I thought as well on the script. And then the tag. Oh, sorry. Something is falling. And then a tag from Esther. So I'm just going to put a little bit of glue here because now if I. Oh, that's too much else. If I glue that down, the twine will stay in place. And I'm going to actually cut that off a little bit. Going to put it here. And then because this is now raised, so I'm going to put a little bit of foam tape underneath there. And this I'm going to trim this down. Yeah, the candles are absolutely fabulous. Fabulous. So you have a fabulous page and you have a fabulous thing to use for cards as well. So I have some foam tape here. I have some old piece here that I can use. Thank you. Yeah, it's a simple, the candles are actually not hard to make. The candles are not hard to make, I have to say. Thank you. And I like the merry everything. It's kind of, you know, cool. These days you need to be happy with everything, isn't it? So I'm just going to put a piece of foam tape here and then put this down straight, and then you have your beautiful cards. So that's that one. And if you want to kind of make the same layout for a page, I would recommend to look online. If you look at Pia's page, I think she posted it today, you will see she just used two layers of the poinsettia and just put them flat. And that is really nice as well. Oh, four. Yeah, scissors I have more as well. I have a little bucket on each workspace. Well, I have three main workspaces, two kind of desks across from each other, and then my die cutting station. And I have a little bucket with scissors and tweezers at each station. That, you know, cannot do without that. Okay, I'm wondering if I get to the candles again today. But because I want to put this one together. Or shall I do the candle? No, let's do this one first. So what I did with this one, and again, I don't know if I completely finish it. Is this dry? It's dry. So this is going to be my first page. So I used Planet Essentials 1 for this one. And then I leave that tab. I used the same die for this one and I just trimmed it off. But and this one, what I did is I put a little bit of adhesive here and just in the center, because I don't want this to be glued down. So now the challenge is, of course, to kind of line it up perfectly. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with this one, because I like it to line up here perfect. Sometimes, because with this one, if I don't do it perfect and I have a little bit of paper left here, I can trim it off. On the other side, it doesn't look that nice. So I'm going to start with this side. I'm going to put this, so I only did like a 6mm tape there. Oh, it's not stuck. Wait, there we go. Just going to put this down a little bit. And this, and then what I do as well, most of the time, I take a piece of release sheets, which I have here. Oh, that's actually from in between rolls of tape. But that's the same. So this is the same as from your tape. So non-stick on both sides. And I'm going to pull it towards me a little bit because I need to start lining it up perfectly. I'm going to start here in the corner. Am I in this? Yeah, I am. Yeah. So just lining it up here and put it down this way a bit. And then I'm going to line it up here against the line. So I have it nicely lined up here. And here, you see, and now I can start my way back. And then if I have a little bit of, because sometimes that happens, and I don't know if that's because your tape is there. You see, I already see I have a little line left there. But I'm totally fine with that, because that is easy to trim off for me. So now I'm going to take all the release sheets off. Oh, here I actually take the whole tape off. That's not, I need to press it down. You see, and I know Esther is using wet glue, but for me, it just works perfectly. You just kind of need to find your way how to do it. There we go. You see, and now I'm still going to see that I line it down. I'm just going to put my strips away here. Going to line it down. So I'm going first here. Here, and I can still put like that release sheet in between here. And it's just to make sure that it doesn't drop down and you cannot take it off anymore. You see, I go this way. And then I'm just going to press this down. Well, it's actually pretty perfect this time. I only have a little piece, like a tiny little piece here, what I will trim down. But it actually went really well. And it's not always that perfect, because here it's all perfect. Here I have a little piece. So what I just will do, I will take my craft mat and I will just trim that off here with a craft knife. Oh, thank you, Ruli. It was fun, I have to say, you know, and honestly, I am really working with all the collections now, and it's so much fun. I have stamped images already from the beautiful blooms that I want to put in there, and yeah, it's really, really nice. Okay, so that's that. You see, but I didn't want to have this pressed down because I want to build on that. kind of slide the tree underneath there a little bit. Or, and what I'm going to do first is I have the trees here, and I'm going to put that buck in the front. Just going to see how I want to build it up. Kind of the smaller tree. Yeah, I think that's what it's going to be. And for this one, I'm just going to put a 3 mil tape here in the middle, because again, I don't want to have it pressed down all the way. And there was something else I saw this week when it was kind of fun. So the deer and the buck, they're not always, well, they're nice to each other. I never see them, you know, they make a sound or whatever. But when he is, of course, he's the dominant one. And then when there's food, the deer and actually the mom will do the same with the kids. They kick them on the butt. So if they want them to go away, they get you know, he kicks her on the butt, like at the back, and then she goes away. But now I saw, it was funny to see, I've never seen it before, but if you have trees, that one, the mother, is actually a smart one, because she can go anywhere, because she doesn't have the antlers. So she kind of walked through the trees away, and then he got stuck. He needs to walk around, because he cannot go with his antlers everywhere. So I thought, okay, good, well done, mum. Well done, mum, I thought. That was kind of cool to see. That was kind of cool to see. So if you observe a little bit, you kind of learn as well. So what do you say? I can't wait to start my journal. So many. I know. There are, so for me, it's really going to be the December day by day. And the journal your December. I just love it at the moment. I'm just totally into it. So I just did a little bit of glue on the legs here. And I might do a little bit here to kind of hold the head down a little bit. Then the tree goes behind there. Crushed pine cones for the ground. Yeah, that actually, when I was at home, that actually went through my mind already. So I might do that. Or I might put a little bit of real grass there as well. So now the mom is going in the back there. You see, I want to put her up a little bit higher. Because that's how it is where we are. It's kind of, you know, that's... I see. I have some snow here. So I'm actually going to put a little piece of 3D. Because otherwise that that stuff will... the snow will kind of change my deer. So I'm just going to take a little piece of foam tape. Let me see. Yeah, I know, Ruli. That was fun. I thought, oh, smart cookie. I know, but keep it in mind when you're wearing your antlers. But can you imagine? It was really fun to see, because he kind of, you know, because he kicked her, and then she just walked through the trees very quietly, and he got stuck. And I never saw that before, so I thought, oh, that's actually cool. So I learned something again. So I'm just going to put her kind of here in the trees, and then I want to have one of the little ones kind of hiding. Oh, the tree is going to go there as well. And then I can just go over the tree and build there, of course. I have two little ones, because I notice a lot of the moms have two little ones, actually. And they're still all still there. Because our neighbor had a video from a mountain lion this week. And a mountain lion with two cubs walking on our driveway. So that's not good for the deer. Or for the fox, or for James, or for myself probably as well. Just want to have this underneath here. Yeah. I should have put that down first, else. Can I still do that? I think I can. And this will be covered partly by the wort as well. There. She's down, 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 down. And it's not straight, like that. Oh yeah, you know, it's, this is fun to do. I really like to play. Yeah, I like the greens of shade as well. So because it was going to be my first page, so I thought, you know, then I keep it kind of, quiet, I don't know. And of course, it's a loose leaf system. So if I think that later on I want to have, I see a question about where the deer is. I will show you the collection in a second. I will show you that in a second. You know, let's put him here or with the mum, kind of, you know. But then he needs to be a little bit behind the tree as well. Kind of hiding there. So that one there. Then I have one left. Let me see if I want to put them. Oh, I can put him here. Yeah, that's good. I know, this is such a great set. Yeah. Domherten, yeah. Yeah, Domherten, yeah. I think that's it. The only thing that we always have a, like if I say elk, and then people say, oh, what are elk? And they're not reindeers. Elk are wapitis in Europe. But I don't know if they're there, but you see, and I love that page. I love kind of the simplicity and, you know, just really, really nice. And then I had my, I think I want to have this one here. So December day by day. So, and then this one needs to have foam tape for sure. But I'm actually going to see if I, I also have this one, Hello December. I like that as well. Oh, I don't know yet. I might leave that for now because I need to think about that one. And then I also have, but I'm not going to use it with this one, but I already saw somebody doing that. So this is for the Sidekick collection, the December day by day. But of course, if you take, and I saw somebody already doing that, if you take this one and you take a ruler, which I was looking for this week and it was actually standing right next to me, there is a stitch line here. So if you just go under that stitch line, I hope I can do it correct if I don't lean in completely, but let me see. So you can see this. I think I'm good. Now I just, my knife needs to be, so I'm just kind of pushing a little bit now. I'm doing it a few times that it doesn't kind of slide. You see, but now you have your December day by day and you can use that in your planner as well. Yeah, mainly, yeah, coyotes we have as well. But the mountain lion, you hardly, you see, but they have, our neighbors have a night camera. And it was there with two cups. And that is, then it's when it's getting tricky. Because you don't want to have a mom with two cups walking on your driveway. How are you using it? Oh, yeah, under the table. Yeah. I do that at my work table at home and I do that here. So the glue is under the table. That's how I clean my fingers here. You see, and you can just do this. You see, and now I can glue this on any page I want. So I think that's a cool idea as well, because you can, I probably would not put it on this one. Yeah, you see, because that's too busy, but I can do it on this one if I want to, like on the other side. And for your information, this video streams to YouTube right away as well. So if you're watching on YouTube, please like it, because then you get, you know, it comes forward easier. So if you're watching YouTube, please like it on YouTube as well. And of course, subscribe to the YouTube channel. So you see, so this one is going to be this one, or but I'm going to work on it. I'm going to see. And this one, by the way, this is stamped on, let me see, I'm going to show you the collection first before I forget that. So, because I got questions about that. So the stamps, first the stamps. So this is the Hello December. And that's the one I just stamped, you see, and with the washi tape. I actually used that already. I used that on a number. And where's that number? I don't know. Then this one, Cozy Days. So it has those circles. And what I did, and I kind of had a chuckle this morning when I was doing this, because in the beginning, I kind of made Esther nuts by saying, Esther, value for money. We need to fill up the space. We need to fill up the space. And now she does, you know, I hardly have to say that anymore. So, because At least not chewing gum under the... No, no chewing gum. No, 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 no. I don't. You know, I actually know somebody from like when I was really young, a friend who did that at home, but no, not chewing gum. So what Esther did is, and I know she showed it us. So these circles, they all cut out. So these stamps, they actually fit on the circles. So this one is one that's in another set. No, this one. Oh, this one is this one. And then this one is this one. And this one with the stitching, kind of squashy, is that one. So fabulous, of course. So, and it's very easy to line it up because if you look at your stamp, let me show you my die. Here. So if you have this stamp, so I stamp first and then you just put this over here and it's very easy to see how to line it up. And then you run this through. So that is actually a really easy way to do that. So very proud of Esther that she did that. Then here we have the weekly thoughts. So this is for your sidekick. You can use it in your planner as well, of course. But that is just 7 days of the week, little text there that fit things. And then here you have all those little words. I love that. Then this one is the note pieces and that die set. I know we might still have a few in Europe, but they're on their way, but they didn't make it on time. But the note pieces, that is an earlier set from Esther, and let me get it for you. It's this one. I don't have a number on it, but it's called note pieces as well. Oh, here, Planner Essentials note pieces, number 1739. And what Esther did is she matched like this one is this one, you see? So this one is this die set. And I know a lot of you will have it already. This one is this die set, or the die, sorry. And then this one is this, you see? So she kind of made it matching, and then the other one is this one. And then it's just a super cool set. So I used for that little tag I just showed you where I don't know it is anymore. Oh, here it is. Wait. Oh, I have my three. So this one I used this one. And then you have those little like the top pieces that go over it, but I didn't put the color in there yet. So that's the note piece. I know a lot of you will have that, but in the US, I know for sure it's not in stock yet. We have a little transfer order coming from Europe, and that is that on its way already, Mark? Do you know? The transfer order? No. You will know, but they will come. They will come back for sure. They will come back, and then. So that's that stamp set, and then here the monthly overview. So that is from the for all the days for to make a calendar. This one fits in your planner as well. And what Pia did, she put it on the, I think on the first page of her December day by day, and then on the back of the first page. And I thought that was a fun idea because then you can kind of make little notes, or if there's birthdays or whatever, you can put that on there. So I thought that was a fun idea. All the little words as well, and then the months there. You see, and Michelle, you see here are all the months, and they are fabulous. And then the calendar numbers, which you'll see in the. So that's that one, and then quickly the dies as well. And I don't think we get to the, you know, those candles. They will happen. They will happen. But so this is the Irish Shutter. It's 1911, and Esther has a fabulous video about this one. A fabulous video. So make sure to check that before you start this one. Look up the video so you can find it on the Esther Glass on you on YouTube, and you can also find it on our YouTube channel because that's so the Irish Shutter. Look it up. Don't try to figure it out yourself. Because we made that video for estimated video for you, so it's very easy to handle. This is the candle page, so that is Planner Essentials 45 1912 candle page for the people that one lady was asking that. Then here we get that Planner Essentials number 1913, Planner Essentials 46, and that is the day by day page. And that is this one, which is fabulous. So there's all those little doors in there. And here you see Esther used the stamp on there. Absolutely love it. Love it, love it, love it. And I know Marie Claire made a really nice one in black and white already. So make sure to check out ECD Planners and Journaling and Journal Your December. Or sorry, Journal With Us, not Journal Your December. Journal With Us, that page, because there you'll find all the inspiration from Ilse and Charlene as well. Then this one, that's the one I just worked with. Planet Essentials 47. And then, of course, the trees. And I know we talked about it already. The trees are from, the other ones are from the Mason jar, which is, of course, a fabulous set that a lot of you have already as well. So that's the trees that I used on my page. So that's from the Mason jar. And of course, the penguins will absolutely make it into my journal in my December day by day. And the Mason jar is actually in there already as well, because that's what I told I was going to do. I'm going to do the new pages and then I'm going to add to it. So for me, this one, the Wave Pocket, is a big one. We have that in the Sidekick as well. And then this one is the Mason jar, you see. And those are the stems from the Beautiful Blooms. And don't forget, if you're interested in the design team, make sure to check out our Facebook page to be a brand ambassador for Josette's collection or the Beautiful Blooms. Here you have those large numbers. Those are not the ones. Where do I have those? Well, there's two on here. That's actually from Esther. You see, I love those. And that's the tag. So that's the paper from the book. The tag is from the book. And then you see the little stamp here. Hip, hip, hooray. So this is great for if you do it like for a birthday card. Somebody's turning 14. And then it says hip, hip, hooray. Fantastic. Fantastic. Those are the large numbers. And then here you got the Sidekick one. So that is Sidekick Essentials 19. You have those reinforcements here. And this is Remember This Forever. And you can do exactly the same, of course, with that Remember This Forever than I did with the December Day by Day, the little text. And that's the last circle I use. So this one, the stamps also fit that circle. Love that. And then that's the little deer. So that's the one I have in here. And this was fun to make. Fun to make. But then, of course, this one now will fit in my journal as well. You see, the big one from Ilse and Charlene will fit in it. So there's so much to mix and match. Absolutely love that. Here's the little snow globe. And behind here, I stamped with one of the stamps from the Beautiful Blooms. The little trees are from an earlier one with the truck. There's so much, so much, so much. And then this is the last one. That is the Essentials 21, number 1918. And that is that overlay page. Let me show you that quickly as well. Where's my Sidekick? Here it is. That is this one. So that gives you an overlay with the stitching. Needless to say that this size, that overlay size, will work really well in your planner as well. So it all mixes and matches. That's from the Beautiful Blooms as well. And here you see that December day by day, how it looks in there. You see what I cut off here, how it looks in your Sidekick. So that is it. So the candles need to wait again for next time. It will happen because I want to make glitter candles, do some, you know, there's so much to do with it. But you see them here already. That slide underneath there. And this is my page. So I will work on that when I'm home. And then finish that. And I will absolutely post a picture of that one as well. And I will work on a candle page. So I have lots and lots to do. You see that I need to figure out. So that's why I sometimes leave a page alone. Because it needs to be perfect. So I just like it to be that I think, okay, that's it. So that is it for today, Mark. Let's turn the camera around. So let's finish this with sound. So I want to wish you all a fantastic weekend, and it is December. So December day by day, and journal your December, and go to the planner and journaling page from Elizabeth Craft Designs and the journal with us for this one, and get lots of inspiration from there, and contact your local store to order this fantastic collection now, because they have it or it's on its way. Thank you.